Hello everyone, here is another video for OrcTube channel. In this video, I'm going to explain alpha halogenation of carboxylic acid or Hell-Volhard-Zelinsky reaction. Here is a generic equation for Hell-Volhard-Zelinsky or HVZ. For alpha halogenation of carboxylic acid, we need to have two-step reaction. In step one, we have to have a halogen, and also we need to have phosphorus halide. And in second step, we need water. And for product for this reaction, we will have one halogen on alpha carbon. Let's see what is the mechanism of this reaction and what is the role of each of these reagents in this reaction. In carboxylic acid, there is a resonance between these two oxygen, and because of this resonance, the carboxylic acid, they don't form enols. To solve this problem, we need to convert this hydroxy group to halogen. So by using PX3, like PBr3, we can convert this carboxylic acid to the acid halide. In this case, acid bromide. Then right now, because there is no resonance, this part can form an enol. Then this enol, like the enol in aldehyde and ketone, it can react with halogens. So the lone pair of oxygen come back to the carbon, and this double bond attack to the bromine and kick the other bromine out. Then we have this intermediate plus bromide anion. This bromide anion can take back hydrogen and produce the neutral product. If we want, we can separate this product, but our goal is put one halogen on alpha position of carboxylic acid. So by adding water to this product, water can easily attack and expelling this bromine, and we eventually have alpha bromo carboxylic acid. If instead of water we add alcohol like R'OH, then instead of OH we can have OR and form alpha bromo ester. Let's see some example for both of alpha bromo carboxylic acid and alpha bromo ester. Here is the first example. All we should do is rewrite the structure for reactant. Then on alpha position, we need to put halogens. Please keep in mind that we need to put this halogen. So if we have different halogen for phosphorus halide and halogens, we always take a look to this part. Then we can have bromoacetic acid. One of the important applications of alpha bromo carboxylic acid, we can easily convert them to amino acids by using excess ammonia, and this bromine can be replaced by NH2 group, and we can have alpha amino acid, which is very important. Here is another example. Then again, we rewrite the structure for reactant. Then on alpha position, we put the halogens. And again, we need to take a look to the X2, not PX3. So we should put a bromine on this alpha position. For all of this example, we can easily convert them to the amino acids by reacting the product with ammonia. Here is next example. Again, we have halogens on alpha carbon. We always need to make sure that there is hydrogen on that alpha position when we want to write the product. Here is the next example, benzoic acid. The alpha carbon in benzoic acid, it doesn't have any hydrogen. So we don't have any product, so the reaction won't happen here. Actually, the carboxylic acid converts to the acid bromide, then acid bromide react with water, and at the very end, we have the reactant. So the net reaction is zero and we don't have any reaction. Let's see a couple of examples for formation of ester. So we rewrite the structure On alpha position, we should have bromine. But because at the end of reaction, instead of water, we add methanol. So instead of OH, you are going to have OCH3. So basically, when we have this intermediate, methanol attack and kick bromine out, and then bromine take hydrogen of alcohol. So we have this alpha bromo ester, and we can also convert this alpha bromo ester to alpha amino ester. Here is the next example. On alpha position, we should have bromine, but instead of OH for carboxylic acid, we should have OR. And here is the last example. On alpha carbon, we should have chlorine. So one chlorine here. And instead of OH, we should have OR. So we have alpha chloro ester. And if we perform reaction between this product and excess ammonia, then we are going to have NH2 instead of chlorine, and we can form alpha amino esters. Of course, if we have suitable condition, that NH3 can also expelling this ester group, but the alpha carbon is a lot more reactive and we can selectively perform this reaction. Thank you for watching this video. For watching more video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.